Hey everyone, it's Dr. Rick, and today's interview is with Tony Figueroa out of the Endorphin Effect. Hey coach, how are you?
How are you?
All right, good.
Good, thanks, Tony.
So, coach, I wanted to tell our viewers about your story. It's amazing. But I guess we have to start with the basics. How did you get to Endorphin Effect, and what do you do here?
I got to Endorphin Effect through Miwa, who opened up the gym, and I've been here now 3 years, and now I'm a training manager as well.
From our discussions in the past, I found out about some common things that we shared. Would you mind going through some of the highlights of where you've been as far as growing up?
I grew up in the projects in Chicago, tough neighborhoods, and I mean, it was a tough time for all of us and our families, a group of seven of us, and you know, learning to fight in the streets and being more disciplined as well was a tough choices to make on the streets, but we did what we had to do and we pretty much all survived through that.
I tell you, the chances of folks making it out of the inner city are really low, unfortunately, but to see you prosper and to see you now using or showing your craft to others to also be just as successful, really cool.
When I got to 8 and 9 years old, I got more involved with it, and it became more fun. At the same time, it became a challenge. So those were things I was learning to control the anger and being more patient in the boxing ring and being self-disciplined, and that really helped a lot.
Hang on a second, Tony. So you're talking about when you were young, you did box with USA Boxing?
No, I actually just boxed and doing some little amateur fights.
Right. I think you mentioned something about bodybuilding or exercise.
Yeah, as I grew up and got older, while I was boxing, I got more involved with the fitness industry and finding out that, you know, there was more than just boxing out there. There was a lot of other things that I wanted to challenge myself for. And then I wanted to do some competition. So that was fun. And I did that for 4 years.
Like amateur or pro level as far as bodybuilding?
No, I actually got to amateur, but the challenges were really awesome. Learning how to eat properly, the right nutrition, to be on stage, and getting lean and cutting up, and also bulking up for off season. And then getting back in, it's a really, really tough challenge and such a disciplined sport as well.
I used to be one of the ringside physicians for USA Boxing, and the weight classes are very strict.
Yes.
And I noticed sometimes in the weigh-in, before everybody gets to the ring, guys would go there dehydrated, and I mean, they'd be cut.
Yes.
Probably from the coaching and the nutrition changes, but then they'd start to put the fuel in right after the weigh-in.
Yeah, actually, going to fight with my brother at that night, one night of the show at the Aragon Ballroom in Chicago, and we're going to be faced with each other. Our weight was off. I was probably 3 pounds heavier. They told me I have about 15 minutes to take that off. So running up and down the stairs for the whole 15 minutes exhausted me, but I also lost the 3 pounds of water weight. So that was challenging. And then going right back in the ring and fighting.
You know that wrestlers and boxers can move their weight within minutes to hours, and that's amazing to chase that with high performance.
Yes.
I mean, I don't think you were pulling any punches with them, were you?
No, I was a little tired going in the ring after losing 3 pounds.
Right.
But you know what? It worked out the best. I was looking forward to getting hydrated again and eating food just to get my weight back up.
So. I think there are actually some people who still do that. They'll wear the plastic bags or the sauna suits.
Yeah, they still do that.
They still do that anyway. It does work to get water weight off.
Yes.
But that is important because I know some people who will do that. They'll get the water weight up, they'll get on the scale, and they say success.
Yes.
When in actuality, that is a success, but I think you teach people how to get the fat off, not just the water, but the fat off too.
So it's a challenge for that too, is just learning to control your sugar intake and your carbs, and not just physically, it's mentally. And those are things people fall for.
So how do you, with all the crap that's going on, 2020, people are just starting to rock their exercise again and their endurance again, and it's gonna be cold, and there's still more crap headed our way. How do you get people to dig in and invest in routine exercise and nutrition during these times?
Well, during these times, it's been tough for all of us, including myself, being a little depressed and, you know, eating everything. And I figured out what I was doing wrong, and it's not helping, so I fixed that quick. But I had to take care of myself first in order to help everyone else. So I went out and reached out to all clients and friends, making sure that they stay on their point of focus and we could get through this together. So everybody who I talk to every day has been 24 hours pretty much.
Man, that is a sign of a true coach. When you have somebody that goes the extra mile and makes sure that on a weekday night or during times of stress that you're still engaged, or the client is still engaged, that you're going above and beyond.
Yes.
We both have a lot that we share together, and you know as well as I, when we're headed in that direction, sometimes because of where we've been, you can pull out.
Yeah.
But some folks don't understand that. And they'll go continue into the rabbit hole. So I've always tried to get folks with depression and anxiety to embrace the beauty of exercise. I think it really, that's natural, and it's the first step. When you have somebody that says, okay, I'm gonna listen to Tony, he's paying attention to me, how do you design an exercise routine, or if you have a client, for example, that comes in, what are your usual steps to figure out, okay, this is client A, this is client B, how do you put together a plan for them?
Well, you know, sometimes it's for a good trainer to know their clients, they have to really pay attention to them and listen to what they're saying. I do that a lot, and I pretty much pick up on their lifestyle, just how they are, what kind of stress they have in their life, just by talking to me. So it's kind of, they get a little scared from that when I tell them about how they are in their real life, and then they actually like that because I'm being honest about it. And to focus on their food and being the best, it depends on their goals and how far they take in this goal. I mean, if it's a short-term goal, I cannot help you. If it's gonna be a long-term goal, I'm there for you all the way through, because that's what it really is. It's supposed to be a healthy lifestyle.
That's interesting. Yeah, I do have a couple folks in the medicine office. We have some folks that just have a short-term target, and like you, I will say, there might be other goals to look for, but if we want to embrace that first, that's fine, but we're not going to be done.
No.
So sometimes I call that daisy chaining. We give them a goal, say, good job, but then I am there, and so are you, to say, let's go to the next level.
Right.
So, you know, with your history of boxing and then bodybuilding, because there is some really arduous change in nutrition and dehydration, and getting on stage for the pose down when you're totally dehydrated, that's tough.
Yeah.
But how do you deal with, say, a client hitting the wall with injury, whether it's psychology and say, that's it, no more, I can't take it, Tony, or they say, you know what, I am starving, I can't do your nutrition. What do you do in your regimen to get them past that roadblock?
Interesting, Rick. I got so many clients that go through this all the time and every day who I meet, including myself though. But to find their niche, and they're there in the beginning and then they fall apart throughout the times or even through a month. And my job is to make sure that they hold themselves accountable, and I'll take them through the hardest times and they cannot give up. And I really talk to them after they work out. I'll sit with them in the office and figure out what's going on in their life, because if they're taking it out on, I can't eat like this, I can't, it could be from outside of the gym. There's something really happening, and I go reach out for that, and I go digging deep into them. That's why I get to know them so well, and I understand what they're going through, but I will make them not give up, because if you give up, you're just gonna end up in the worst places, and then you're gonna want help later, and it's sometimes it's too late.
All right, you actually sound like a true corner. In boxing, the corner, I mean, the corner's not supposed to say, okay, you're losing, let's just throw in the towel.
Yeah.
Corner's supposed to say, there's a deficiency, let's get past that, and let's embrace our strengths. That is the true calling. In fact, how did you, You have a lot of talents, and you mentioned office. Have you done managerial stuff, or where did you learn all this, the craft?
I started off at Bally's Total Fitness, and then it became Crunch Fitness and Gorilla Sports and all around clubs in the downtown area. I kind of wanted to learn more aspects about fitness since I was involved with it, and I felt good about myself to continue doing education. So Bally's also offered me to be a manager overseeing clubs and helping out other trainers that are young that want future goals for themselves as well, to help out for them, for their needs and for their clients. So there was a lot of learning there, and I really enjoyed it and got certified throughout the years as Bally's paid for everything for me, which thank you,
nice.
Bally's.
Yeah.
And they got me involved with so many, and you know, certifications, and I wanted to be
involved. Sounds like you constantly add on the experience and the training, probably not only to make you a better man, but also to make your client successful in their arduous journeys.
Yeah, it's such a good challenge for those, and it's every day. We learn everything every day. It doesn't matter how much years of experiences you may have or I may have. You still learn every day new things, but it depends on the person you're training, that what may work and what may not work for them. So it's like the science behind it all.
It's true. All the experiences that fly by, we're supposed to grab that, learn from it. But you know as well as I, sometimes in the economic stress or the political stress or just the disease stress of pain and suffering, it's like, I'm not going to learn anything. I'm just going to be right here, and that's where we need coaches to push past that. And maybe it's hand-holding, maybe it's not, but if there's nobody else there, you have a human that's going downhill.
Yes.
And we got too many of that going.
Too many.
Emergency rooms full of that stuff.
Yeah.
And so I think, I feel myself, I have to intervene somewhere, and that's why I always love being here with you. And it sounds like you have found your niche, and you really are dedicated to make that person avoid the emergency room.
Yes, very much, because hospitals are no fun.
So. Yeah, unfortunately.
And, you know, this doctor knows it himself. It's not about medicine and pills. Sometimes people have those needs, but health and fitness, it's really the determination of that, and making it balance your lifestyle with yoga, flexibility with strength and conditioning. I mean, you can really feel good about yourself by nurturing the right foods in your body and avoiding the most medicine you can.
That's nice. So we got a coach that teaches nutrition, got a coach that has been in the ring and gone through the journey of starting with what should be, I mean, honestly, with you, if you look at the statistics, you shouldn't have made it out of the projects. You did, though. And you made it out alive.
Yes.
And now you're teaching other guys. So you're also a teacher. You're physically fit. In fact, I'm just curious, how old are you, Tony?
54.
54 years old. 54 years old with this kind of muscle mass. It's supposed to be normal. But unfortunately, in America, it's rare.
Yeah, most people, I'm not surprised that I'm 54. They think I'm 39, 40. And then they don't believe me when I tell them. But then they're asking me, well, how do you do it? And I said, it's mentally, and you have to make choices in your life. So those are things you have to decide on, what you want to be healthy as you get older. Because it's not easier for so many families to help you if you fall apart. And not everyone will be there for you. So you have to pick yourself up.
You know, we got to be there for our families, got to be there for our relatives, our community. You sound like the perfect coach for all that guidance. So obviously you don't look like you're in your 50s. What do you see yourself doing at the age of 70? So that's like 10 to 15 years from now.
10 to 15 years from now, I'm hoping to lie in a nice beach of sand and just retire my lifestyle, knowing that I accomplished so many other people's goals and made them happy, because that makes me happy.
Very honorable, Coach. So in case we have somebody that wants to reach out to you, how do they go about reaching
you? You can reach out at the Endorphin Effect here at 59 in Bartlett. We have a website there, so reach out to Endorphin Effect and you'll find us and my name on it. I'm always available for any questions or needs.
Excellent. Coach, it's been an honor. Great journey, and I'm glad I'm here with you. I'm going to probably learn a lot of stuff, if you don't mind.
Nope, we're teaming up here.
There you go. Thanks, Coach. Nice. I appreciate it. Nice either to get to Endorphin Effect or call the number. Can you repeat that number one more time, Coach?
Number is 224-266-4927.
Excellent. Keep that in your speed dial, because this man, if you ever get to the point where you're off it or about to jump off the cliff as far as health, nutrition, spirituality, this guy is going to keep you from doing that. Nice going. Thanks.